You now know that building with nature involves the flexible integration of land in water and of water in land, using materials, forces, and interactions present in nature, and taking into account both existing and potential nature values, and the biogeomorphology and the geohydrology of the ambient environment, to paraphrase Dr. Ronald Waterman. So, it's an integrated design approach that considers hydraulics, morphology, ecology, the societal context, and diverse goals. Building with nature is hydraulic engineering at the interface between nature and society. But what does this mean for your design practice? You now know that engineering and ecological principles underpin building with nature design. But how does this differ from the conventional engineering design process? The conventional engineering design process translates societal norms or standards deriving from values into functional requirements that need to be met by the infrastructure. Take the issue of coastal safety. This societal value is captured in a Dutch flood defense standard. For a particular location, such as the dunes on the South Holland coast, this is specified further into a functional requirement to withstand a storm surge with an annual exceedance probability of 1 in 10,000. We're very familiar with this process of designing hydraulic infrastructure to meet societal needs. But what about meeting ecosystem requirements? Do we also translate these into functional requirements? Let's consider the issue of nature conservation. This societal value is expressed, for instance, in the European Union's Habitat Directive. And that's in turn captured in Natura 2000 specified areas in the Wadden Sea, for example. Perhaps you think this solves the issue of building with nature design processes. Just specify both the societal and the ecosystem needs in terms of functional requirements, and then engineers can design appropriate hydraulic infrastructures. But how do you design for conservation and restoration, or provide opportunities for the ecosystem? Well, you already know that the bridge is formed by focusing on the character of the system at the level of the hydraulic and ecological design principles, one level above the functional requirements, and providing a means of checking the effects of any trade-offs on the functional integrity of the ecosystem. Building with nature aims to use natural materials, forces, and interactions to balance hydraulic infrastructural interventions and the needs and the health of ecosystems as far as that's possible. Just like the conventional engineering design process, the building with nature design process has 7 steps in an iterative process. These are: 1. Define the multi-actor, multi-value problem. 2. Include multidisciplinary knowledge, apply HE principles, and specify preliminary functional requirements. 3. Sketch and describe preliminary designs. 4. Select diverse, promising designs in terms of the HE principles. 5. Test or verify through prototyping or modeling. 6. Incorporate relevant new knowledge, revise the functional requirements, refine or redesign, retest, and check in terms of the HE principles. And finally, select the final design for multi-actor evaluation. So how does the building with nature design process differ from the conventional engineering design process? Let's move through each of these steps and clarify the differences. Step 1, define the multi-actor, multi-value problem. This means scoping the problem very widely and taking the diversity of perspectives and values on the issues into account. It represents a fundamentally different starting point, in which a single client is not viewed as representing societal ecosystem needs. There's also a deep acknowledgement of different sources of knowledge on the environment, varying from that possessed by local residents to official data sources. And now step 2. That's including multidisciplinary knowledge, applying the HE principles, and specifying preliminary functional requirements. Here, diverse types of knowledge from ecology to engineering play a role. The environment is described in terms of form and functioning, and the character in terms of the HE principles. Preliminary functional requirements are specified. So are the boundary conditions and the loads. But the first two steps in designing in the Building with Nature design process are very different to those of the conventional approach because of their wide scope and their explicitly open stance to other and diverse knowledge sources. Moving on to steps 3 and 4, the sketching and the subsequent selection of promising designs. These are similar to the conventional method, except that different knowledge is brought to the table, the functioning and character of the ecosystem is included, and the time horizon covers the life cycle of the artifact that is being designed. 5. Test or verify the designs, prototyping and modeling. Ecological assessment and prediction are the additional items used in this step. And now, moving on to step 7, we select the final design for multi-actor evaluation. This step is also very different from the conventional engineering design process. It means that we don't only check whether the functional requirements are satisfied, we cross-check whether the potential solution adheres to the HE principles. We ask for a sound explanation of its performance against the principles, so as to understand where the trade-offs are being made. Only when these aspects are satisfied are the potential solutions evaluated by stakeholders holding very different perspectives. If all of these aspects are not satisfied, we move to the iterative step, step 6, where we incorporate new knowledge, revise the functional requirements, refine or redesign, retest, and check in terms of the HE principles. This represents the iterations needed to improve a design. The differences relate to the possibilities of including new knowledge sources when the design process is already ongoing and revising the functional requirements, both of which are not routinely included in an engineering design process, a conventional engineering design process. So the Building with Nature design process can be depicted like this. And the major differences in the two design processes are first, that in Building with Nature, we adopt a stance that acknowledges complexity. We anticipate the need to include many actors or stakeholders with different perspectives, as well as multiple knowledge sources. So we are accepting of uncertainty, recognizing that natural systems are dynamic and that ecosystems can have unexpected responses. Yet, we think about the long term, about natural dynamics and the life cycle of the artifact. Finally, in Building with Nature, we integrate ecology and engineering using the HE principles. After all, Building with Nature is a balancing act involving trade-offs in multidisciplinary design space. Thank you for your attention.